Hi, and thanks for joining us for Hip Hop from the 1980s to the Present. Hip Hop originated in the 1970s as a form of activism, expressionism, and empowerment. Hip Hop has gone through many phases throughout the decades. Unfortunately for women, the changes have led to a path fraught with misogyny and violence. The 1980s hip-hop scene was great for women. Music was radio-friendly with minimal explicit themes or language used. Songs had strong female-centered content and empowered themes and lyrics. Females became widely accepted and seen as equals. Female artists emerged into the scene. Salt and Pepper, Queen Latifah, MC Light are examples of a few. Of the early 1990s, fronted by groups such as Tribe Called Quest, De La Soul, and Public Enemy. Their music was Afrocentric, which meant it was focused on the empowerment of the African-American culture. Afrocentric hip-hop gave African-American women authority and status. This was the era of hip-hop that gave women the most power. The Afrocentric 90s rap group Arrested Development are remembered for their positive and influential messages.
Up everybody, the bottom line. I'm a black intellect, but I'm refined. With precision like the bullet, target bound. Just living like a hookup, the Harlot sounds. Now, when I say the Harlot, you know I need the hot. Beat a greater, the breakfast in the pot.
Jalik, you wind up, yeah.
Drafting of the poets, I'm the number 7 pick. Licks, boy, when your backside. Licks, boy, when your backside. Listen to the beat of Shaheed, let's it collide. Tip to everybody, heaven's on my side. Even in Santa Domingo.
Hip-hop of the mid to late 1990s. With the emergence of Wu-Tang Clan, Nas, Notorious B.I.G., and Tupac, hip-hop fell from grace and power and slid straight into drugs, sex, violence, and misogyny. Lil' Kim helped further the negative stereotypes of African-American women and women in general by her use of provocative attire, sexual lyrics, and the acceptance of demeaning gender roles via video and print media releases. These artists favored to create music that was party-oriented rather than empowering and transformative. And now for hip-hop of the 2000s. This era was seen as heavily misogynistic in its themes in the song lyrics and in video content. Female artists began to dress as sex objects, and the focus turned from lyrical content to the shape of the body. The focus was on women as objects, particularly useful for sex and pleasure. The once powerful collective of female artists are now forgotten.
She the best. that's when the vulture devoured me. I was president. I get elected on Friday. Assassinated on Saturday. Buried on Sunday. They go back to work on Monday.
Hip-hop of today, money versus values. Strong female and male artists are slowly infiltrating the scene, although the toll of the last 15 years of misogyny and moral ineptitude has severely damaged the quality of the lyrical and visual content. Artists such as Lauryn Hill, Wyclef Jean, and Erykah Badu bring hope to many. They have helped bring a rebirth to the old-school ideals of hip-hop. Their music promotes empowerment, strength, and the breaking down of damaging stereotypes of African-American women and men everywhere.